here at the St. Johnsburg Fire Hall. Will Calrissian, kind enough to stop by for a couple moments. Had an interesting conversation right before we went on camera.
Oh, yeah.
Started training when you were in 2001?
2001. I was the ripe old age of 16 years old.
We're not breaking any laws.
No, just bending them.
Bending them.
Yes.
My goodness. 2001, you started training. You were 16 years old in the ring with adults.
Yes. Actually, my best friend was a 34-year-old man. Still keep in touch with him. He's the best man at my wedding. And we got along swimmingly, which speaks miles about his maturity level.
Right. Now, you're in the ring with adults. How awkward? Was there any awkwardness? Or
not really, because at the time, there was a group of guys from high school that were anywhere from 16 to 18 that started together. I'm just the last one standing. So.
My goodness. Okay, how much has the business changed since then?
A lot. I personally just took off about 2.5 years. I have 3 beautiful little girls at home, so I needed to take time to raise them and with my wife, and I couldn't dedicate the amount of time I wanted to wrestling. So I took some time off, and I just recently came back, and I'm learning more from these young guys than they're learning from me, which is a testament to their talent level and their skill. But things have changed so much. Like when I was trained, you do one torpedo dive. Now you do 3 in succession. Yeah, you know, things just change. So
yeah, 3 little girls. You had a family and everything like that. That's the part of this business that people don't get to see.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a decision that you had to make at that point.
Yeah, I always wanted a family, and I I've been doing it since I was 16, and my wife. I had some injuries here and there, nagging ones, and my wife was kind of on me to, you know, really evaluate and think about it. What is this gonna? Are you gonna make this anything? And I decided to, like I said, I couldn't commit the time I wanted to it, so I decided to hang it up for a bit, and then I just missed it so much. I missed the camaraderie, I missed everything about it. So we had a nice long talk, and here I am today, getting back into it. So,
but that's the whole thing, though. I mean, it's what kind of brought you back is that you miss the atmosphere.
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. So okay, now the ultimate question: growing up, who made you a fan?
Ooh. who made me a fan?
Who sucked you into this? And who are we to blame for all this?
The Rock sucked me in, but
it was Miss Piggy. That shrimp.
That sultry swine. The Rock brought me in, but what made me want to become a wrestler is Eddie Guerrero and I don't know if I could say it, but Chris Benoit.
Ooh.
Yeah.
It's okay to say Chris Benoit here.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I think it's tragic what happened, obviously. Yes. So, but those were the two that made me want to become a wrestler. Man. And Dean Malenko, the Iceman, the man of 1,000 holds.
Man, I'll tell you what, one of the most underrated technical guys ever.
PWI 500, number 1, 1997. Look it up, children. History.
Oh, my goodness. Well, Mr. Calrissian, thank you very much.
My pleasure.